You guys, look at that.
What is that?
Yeah, what is that?
What is it?
Right? So did you know that if the crow crows three times in the crow field before dawn, the scarecrow will scare the crow away?
Yeah, but if the sky is blue and the clouds are white, wouldn't it bring in the turtle to the sea?
Yeah, but if the sea was flowing beyond the wind that the winds could push, then the grass really wouldn't be green. Do you see what I'm saying?
I do.
Okay. You get it?
For sure.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, what do we want? Here's a kiddie pool. Yeah.
Let's go stand under the mushroom.
Dog, we've been waiting 10 minutes for this stop sign to turn green.
For real, bro, what the hell?
I'll check it out. Gonna turn green or what? I don't know, it's still red. This is a big tube. You need some help? Here. I got you. All right, I don't want you to be afraid, but the dragon's right over here. It's okay. It's okay. Okay, here's another one for you.
It's your science fun fact of the day.
Just out here learning things.
Okay, you guys saw my last video, and I was talking about how everything on this earth is perfectly designed to work for one another. Everything works together. Here's something that I just found out, and it absolutely just blows my mind, okay? So, as we know, there are vascular and non-vascular plants. Now, a vascular plant has vein systems. They're special channels that allow the plant to transport its water and its nutrients, giving it the ability to pull from the ground and grow high. A non-vascular plant, like moss, for example, doesn't have that ability. It has to pull its water and its nutrients from the leaf itself. So it has to stay low to the ground so that it can get that water and get that nutrients. A vascular plant is super special. It has something called stomas. Now on a microscopic level, here, I'll pull it up so you can see. On a microscopic level, vascular plants have what are called stoma. And a stoma is basically like a little tiny mouth that allows the plant to receive extra sunlight and extra water. Scientists say that the plant has anywhere to up to around 300 stoma per square millimeter. Now that's a lot. Stoma rely on a few different environmental stimuli to make them open and close. Some of those things being heat, light, CO2 levels, but those things fail.
And is what really blows my mind
is that the stoma sometimes, if not a lot, rely on birds. They literally rely on the sounds of the birds singing their sweet songs to make them open up so that they can receive extra sunlight and extra water. It is just so crazy to me how everything works together, guys. It's just so crazy because the last time that I checked, birds literally live in trees. They're designed to live in trees. Like, think about that. Creation, everything is designed to work together. Oh, and vascular plants make up about 80% of plants. Science. Fun fact of the day.
What are you doing?
I'm a little scared.
Yeah, right, son!
Dog, this is a yeet and a half, bro.
Yeet to you. Man. Oh, look at them.
So this one morning, like super duper early in the morning, I woke up out of bed. But really, I was under the bed because I knew I had a lot of chores to do that day and I didn't want to have to make the bed when I woke up. So I went to sleep prepared. First things first, I grabbed the shampoo and dumped a little bit into the sink because I knew it's been a minute since the sink was conditioned. So I just stirred that around and let it soak for a little bit. Then it was time to get down to the nitty and gritty. I flipped the chair and I made sure that it got Febreze on all four legs. Then I was around in the kitchen, but I was kind of confused because I didn't know where my potato was. But then I remembered I left it over here in the apple jar. And then everything was kosher. So I started to tinker around with the bike, but there was too much stuff in the way for me to pull it out. So I said, you know what, never mind. Then I went to go inside, but then I heard some disturbance in the forest. So I grabbed some tools and went to go see what the noise was. Opened that door just to find out my journey wasn't going to be that far because it was the wind chimes making some noise. So I set the camera down and went to work. Saw, 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 saw. Cut, cut. Yeah. Ding, ding, ding. Then I listened. Yep, everything was good. So I went back inside. Last but not least, I had to read my book because it's been a few days since I read my book. So I opened it up. I flipped through the pages really fast, read it, and then put it away. Now that my chores were done, I could finally chill, so I did just that.
Well, Pimperella, you made it to the end of the videos, and like always, I hope I was able to inspire you and make you laugh. Quite frankly, I just want to give a huge thanks to birds for keeping them chirps chirping. Stay fly, my dogs. Stay fly. See you next time.